Good morning friends, good morning students. In today's class we'll discuss fatty acid oxidation, right? So first of all we start with numbering. So this is carboxylic acid group, this is a normal fatty acid, right? The numbering is done from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, right? And this carbon adjacent to the carboxylic group is known as alpha carbon, beta carbon and delta and so on, right? And the omega numbering is done from the methyl group side, right? Omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, omega 4 and so on, right? Now in fatty acid oxidation the most common oxidation is beta oxidation, right? And beta oxidation the main sites are liver, adipose tissue and muscle. Now how will you define beta oxidation, right? So this is the alpha carbon and this is beta carbon, right? The oxidation at beta carbon of fatty acid is known as beta oxidation, and this oxidation occurs between alpha and beta carbon right here, right? And the oxidation of beta carbon will lead to the formation of 2-carbon acetyl-CoA, right? And this is how fatty acid is degraded. Now as we have already discussed that the major organs are liver, adipose tissue and muscle, where beta oxidation take place. And which organelles take place? It is mitochondrial matrix. And beta oxidation is supposed to happen in 3 proper steps. The first step is activation of fatty acid, right? And the second step is transfer of fatty acid from cytosol to the mitochondria, right? And the third step is beta oxidation proper in the mitochondrial matrix, right? The activation is supposed to happen in cytosol, right? And from cytosol the fatty acid is brought into the matrix by transfer. It is by carnitine shuttle, and the carnitine shuttle is used, right? And in proper third step there will be beta oxidation proper in the matrix. Now I will start with the first step, that is activation of fatty acid. Now in this first step, activation of fatty acid, the fatty acid is activated by ATP to form acyl adenylate, right? And this acyl adenylate is reacted by coenzyme A to form acyl CoA, right? And this ATP is formed to converted to form pyrophosphate, and 2 inorganic phosphates are released, right? So this makes the reaction irreversible, right? And these reactions require 3 things, that is ATP, coenzyme A, ATP here, coenzyme A and magnesium for this reaction. And the acyl CoA formed, that is activated, is formed in the cytosol, right? And it is impermeable to the mitochondrial matrix, right? So in this second step we will transfer this coenzyme A into the mitochondrial matrix, and for this we'll use carnitine shuttle system, right? Now we'll start with second step, that is carnitine shuttle. Now in second part, in the first step we activated the fatty acid to form acyl CoA, right? And this acyl CoA is in the cytosol, and it is supposed to brought back into the mitochondria for a proper beta oxidation, right? But it is impermeable to the matrix, this inner mitochondrial membrane, right? So to do this, acyl CoA binds with carnitine, right? And the acyl group is taken up by carnitine to form acyl carnitine, right? The enzyme uses carnitine for palmitoyl transferase 1, right? And this acyl carnitine is permeable to the inner mitochondrial membrane, and it will reach here in the matrix, right? For proper beta oxidation, right? And this acyl carnitine is acted upon again by coenzyme A, and the zyme is carnitine palmitate transferase 2, right? And this breakdowns acyl carnitine to form acyl CoA, and this carnitine is regenerated, right? And this carnitine again comes back to the cytosol for regeneration for uptaking the acyl CoA, right? Now acyl CoA from the cytosol is now, it has reached in the mitochondrial matrix where it will proceed for beta-oxidation, right? And chemically this carnitine is beta-hydroxy gamma trimethyl amino butyrate, right? And this carnitine shuttle is second step, because in the first step we activated the fatty acid to form acyl CoA, right? And in the second step the acyl CoA is brought into the mitochondrial matrix by this carnitine shuttle. Now in the third step we will start with proper beta oxidation, right? Now in the third step there is proper beta oxidation, and to remember proper beta oxidation I have made a mnemonic, that is OHOC, right? There are four steps in proper beta oxidation and they are remembered by mnemonic OHOC. O for oxidation, then H for hydration, then O for oxidation, then C for cleavage. 1, 2, 3, 4, OHOC, right? Now here I have drawn this acyl CoA that was activated in the first step, then it is brought into the mitochondrial matrix, and now this acyl CoA is in the mitochondrial matrix, and here it is undergoing four steps, that is O, H, O, and C, oxidation, hydration, oxidation and cleavage. And in the first step this acyl CoA is activated by acyl CoA dehydrogenase, and in this reaction FAD is converted to FADH2, right? And this reaction generates 1.5 ATP, right? And first step is clear, oxidation by FAD to form FADH2, and 1.5 ATP is generated, and acyl CoA is converted to form transuronic CoA, right? And in the second step there is OH, H for hydration, and we are adding a molecule of water to this step. And here this hydroxy group is attached here, and it is known as beta hydroxy acyl CoA. Beta carbon is here, beta hydroxy acyl CoA, right? And in the third step there is again O, that is oxidation, and it is by NAD is converted to NADH, right? And here we generate 2.5 ATP, right? Or this NAD is converted to NADH plus S positive, right? And this is third oxidation step, and it happens by enzyme dehydratase, right? And this here C double O group is there, and we finally form beta keto. Keto group is there, beta keto acyl CoA, right? And the final step, that is OHOSC, C for cleavage, right? Here we will cleave this compound beta keto acyl CoA into two molecules. One is acyl CoA and second is acetyl CoA, right? And these are both two carbon moieties, and acetyl CoA will enter the TCA cycle, right? And this acyl CoA is regenerated and it enters here for further cycles, right? And there are proper seven cycles are there for proper beta oxidation, right? Now this beta oxidation is over. Now we'll start with energetics of this beta oxidation. I will start with palmitic acid, and then I will explain stearic acid as well. Now in energetics we discuss the complete cycle now, and in one cycle we generate one NADH and one FAD, right? So total seven cycles are there in oxidation of palmitic acid, that is it contains 16 carbon, right? And for seven cycles we will get 7 FAD and 7 NADH, right? And 1 FAD generates 1.5 ATP, and 1 NADH generates 2.5 ATP. So total 10.5, 17.5, and there are total 8 acetyl CoA are formed, and one acetyl CoA enters the TCA, it generates 10 ATP, right? And from 10, when we multiply by 8, we'll get 80 ATP, right? And so total energy from one molecule of palmitol will be 108, but during the first step of activation we use 2 ATP, right? Then we'll form fatty acid activation, and acyl CoA was activated and 2 ATP phosphates were used, right? And we'll minus then 2, and total 106 ATG are formed from 16 carbon palmitic acid, right? And now in case of stearic acid, for example, it contains 18 carbons, right? And it undergoes 8 cycles total. 8, so 8 into FAD, 8 into NADH, and 9 into 10 for acetyl CoA, right? And finally, we minus 2 ATP as well for the activation, and we'll get total 120 ATP. Now, in the last step, we have regulation of this beta oxidation, and it is regulated at the level of carnitine shuttle, right? And this carnitine shuttle is inhibited by high levels of melanine CoA. This inhibits the carnitine shuttle, right? So it also is regulated by, during welfare state, we know in welfare state we have high glucose levels, and when we have high glucose levels, we have high insulin levels, right? So when insulin levels are high and glucagon levels are low, right, the body will go for fatty acid synthesis, right? And fatty acid synthesis is taking place, and during fatty acid synthesis we are synthesizing melanyl CoA, right? And these high levels of melanyl CoA will inhibit this beta oxidation by carnitine shuttle blockage, right? And in case of fasting, right, the insulin levels are low and glucagon levels are high. So this ratio is reversed, and in this melanin CoA will not be formed, and when melanin CoA is not there, the beta oxidation will proceed proper and it will proceed further, right? So that finishes with our complete chapter on beta oxidation. And in the coming video, I'll make separate videos on alpha oxidation and mega oxidation and its disorders, right? So that finishes. Please like the channel and subscribe it, and do share with your family and friends. Thank you.